49 sirens are currently out of service, and that's why they want people to continue to sign up for text alerts.
The best way of receiving the initial warning is still the outdoor warning system, but to find out more detailed information, you need to be connected.
The text warnings don't just inform residents of what's on the horizon, but if a problem in the system occurs, like 6 months ago when several sirens malfunctioned.
We don't expect those problems to happen again.
But water, wind, and lightning can still cause issues, so whether it's a false alarm or something real, Ortiz says it's best to sign up, be informed, and stay prepared.
It just takes one storm to really cause a lot of damage.
As a familiar sound of spring is ready to go. In Fort Worth, Chris Van Horn, NBC5.
Well, we have no problem being your human siren, as one of our jobs here at the Weather Channel is to make sure that you are weather ready at all times.
Yeah, that especially holds true for today. So we want to give you some advice to help keep you and your family safe if a tornado warning comes by. And it starts with if you're in a mobile home. What do? Well, you should get out, because most tornadoes can destroy even tied down mobile homes. So get to the nearest sturdy permanent building. Get there as fast as you can.
Now, if you're in your vehicle, you want to seek shelter in a sturdy building. That means get out of your vehicle if you can and go to a sturdy building. Now, don't try to seek shelter under any bridge or any overpass, and drive out of a tornado's path if you can. Now, if you're far enough away from it, by moving at right angles to the tornado.
And if you happen to be at work at the time, like in an office building, you should go to an enclosed windowless area in the center of the building on the lowest floor possible. Interior stairwells are usually great places to take shelter, but you don't want to be is on an elevator. You don't want to be trapped in there if the power's out. And there's a severe threat today. We'll update.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 72. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 86, chance of rain 80%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Whatever their stickers say, they'll all lose suction because their filters clog. But with our sonic tips oscillating at 5,000 hertz, only new Dyson Kinetic Science won't lose suction.
Going to the paint studio at Ace is like going to your neighbor. And hurry in this Wednesday through Sunday for buy 1 gallon, get one free. Save up to $71 when you buy 2 gallons, exclusively at Ace.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
The Fiat 500 isn't alone anymore. It's part of a big Italian family.
She watched him being tortured and killed. Moment by moment.
You think he's coming back?
I know he is.
Mary, he's alive.
Where is your son?
Not here. There's so much pain and despair. That's why my son came to us. To free us from it.
AD, the Bible continues. Easter Sunday, April 5th on NBC.
It tastes better when you grow it. It tastes even better when you share it. It's not hard. It's doable. It's growable. Get going with Growables. Miracle-Gro. Life starts here.
Jack's heart attack didn't come with a warning. Today's doctor has him on a Bayer aspirin regimen to help reduce the risk of another one. If you've had a heart attack, be sure to talk to your doctor before you begin an aspirin regimen.
Right now, somewhere in America, there's an animal being beaten and another being locked in a cage, alone and left to die. These scared, innocent animals don't realize there's any hope for a better life. At the ASPCA, we're committed to searching every dark corner to find them and to help heal the deep physical and emotional wounds that have been inflicted on them. But we can't reach these animals without your support. So please visit our website or call now and join. Sign up for just $18 a month. It's only 60 cents a day, and you'll help rescue animals who are suffering and provide medical care, food, shelter, and love. The situation is urgent, and so we're asking you to join in the next 10 minutes. If you do, we'll send you the photo of an animal from our shelter and an ASPCA t-shirt. If you've wondered if your support will make a difference, I can tell you it will. And if you've ever thought about helping, this is the time. It's a painful and horrifying life for these animals. But for just 60 cents a day, you can change everything. It could be the most important thing you do today. Go online or call right now.
It took James Dyson 5,000 prototypes to invent the bagless vacuum, and another 10,000 to invent the only vacuum that doesn't lose suction, thanks to patented sonic tips. Everything else is history. Search Kinetic now.
Well, my mom and dad have one, and you'll hear it. You'll hear it, and you'll know where to go, and it tells you, I believe they tell you where it's at, how many minutes away.
Warnings save lives. Outside sirens are fine, but when you're inside, the way the houses are built nowadays, you can't hear it. And so by having the radio, it takes care of that.
Yeah, those sirens are meant for you if you're outside, already doing something outside, you can hear a siren. But as the spring season, severe season really gets going, groups like the Salvation Army are trying to get residents in Pilgrim, Nebraska weather ready for this year. They were, of course, deeply affected by last year's deadly tornadoes in the area. So today, residents were receiving free weather radios that started yesterday, continues today.
And along with the weather radios, the group also handed out emergency disaster go bags at the event.
Yeah, and no other weather phenomenon can match the power and destruction of tornadoes. Sustained winds can tear apart buildings and toss trucks like toothpicks.
Yeah, but as severe weather ramps up later today, let's bring in Dr. Greg Forbes because he explains it's the second force that causes the most impressive damage.
It's amazing to see some of the things that a tornado can do. Maybe it shouldn't surprise us, considering that some tornadoes can have horizontal winds over 200 miles per hour and extremely strong updrafts that can pick things up. One of the things that we see a lot are tractor-trailers that get tossed about. At about 15 tons empty, that's pretty impressive. Let's freeze this, and I'll talk about how this happens. The tractor trailer is heavy, but it has a lot of surface. It's about 70 feet long, 13 to 14 feet high. That's a lot of area for the winds to blow against, and some of the tornado winds can get underneath. They can go upwards 100 miles per hour, lift up the tractor trailer, even make it fly. Now I'm going to show you something not as big, not as heavy, but I consider even more impressive. Look at these parking blocks. They weigh 300 pounds, and it's hard to imagine how the wind can get under them. It must take winds that are extremely strong, just within inches of the ground, to be able to begin to roll these, and then it can pick them up and toss them. We think the fastest winds are really about 50 feet above ground. Blocks like these got tossed up to 50 yards. Finally, let me show you something that I consider even more incredible. Some tornadoes have even been known to scour soil right out of the ground. It's hard to understand how that could happen. You can reach down and try to pull some out with your hands, but you'll just tear up some grass. It's difficult even enough to shovel soil out of the ground. We even saw dirt get pulled out of the ground in the EF5 Smithville, Mississippi tornado back on April 27, 2011. Maybe a trench up to the width of a football field and 2 feet deep. It even tore asphalt out of a roadway surface. How do we think this can happen? A combination of wind force and pressure force. Wind force, winds unusually low right down to the ground to push on the soil, while there's a pressure force, maybe a moisture layer underneath that got vaporized pushing upward, while low pressure in the tornado pulled upward and popped the sod right out of the ground.
All right, that's some great information from our Storm Master G. But let's turn now to a different type of windy scenario. Folks are dealing with this across the Southwest. You're looking live now at Los Angeles, where we have hazy conditions, but it's the winds that will come offshore that will create a very warm scenario going through the next several days. Gusty winds for the Los Angeles area. That's the big weather story. But again, these winds are not associated with the storms and the force of storms, but it'll be associated more so with kind of a gradient wind, and I'll explain that in just a moment. But last night, look at the wind reports that we had now from Los Angeles up to Santa Barbara. In fact, at the Mission Canyon area, winds were gusting over 49 miles per hour. Even winds fell on a car near the Lexington Road and the Oxford Way, and the person was actually trapped inside this car. One injury was reported. Again, this was near Beverly Hills. Talk about the gradient wind with high pressure here, low pressure there. It's the pressure gradient between the two that's creating the persistent offshore wind. So another windy, hot day here.
At Ancestry, we call it a hint. Simply type in a name and follow the Ancestry leaf far into your family's past. A past filled with stories that intrigue and inspire. And in doing so, reveal the one unique, improbable, and completely remarkable path that led to you. Discover your story. Start searching for free now at Ancestry.com.
Hey, girl. Is it crazy that your soccer trophy is talking to you right now? It kind of is. It's as crazy as you not rolling over your old 401k. Cue the horns. Just harness the confidence it took you to win me and call TD Ameritrade's rollover consultants. They'll help with the hassle by guiding you through the whole process step by step. And they'll even call your old provider. It's easy. Even she could do it.
Whatever, Janet.
For all the confidence you need, TD Ameritrade. You got this.
It's gonna go fast. Hold on.
Just never know what's gonna happen.
Holy f***, this is cold!
We know you can't control the weather, so we build things to harness it.
Woo! That was a good one.
That's amazing, straight above our heads. That's just incredible.
Man, how do we do that? This is where I want to be right now.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Thursday, thunderstorms. High 86. Chance of rain 80%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Grandpa Bodie, Grandma said you used to be out of control.
Really? I guess I did take some risks. I trained a little bit differently. I was a little too honest sometimes.
The media is useless.
You were out of control.
But not always.
Audi, proud sponsor of the U.S. Ski Team.
Heartburn.
Did someone say burn? Try Alka-Seltzer Relief Chews. They work just as fast and are proven to taste better than Tums Smoothies assorted fruit.
Amazing.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. Enjoy the relief.
You again.
Gorilla Glue. Of course.
Water activated. Original Gorilla Glue expands into the materials to form an incredibly strong bond for the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
With Secret Outlast Clear Gel, you're ready no matter how long your day gets.
Stay still, like a statue. Just like a statue. Really?
Secret's new Clear Gel formula gives you 48-hour odor protection and goes on clear for no white marks.
Look here.
So when your day goes on and on and on, outlast it with new Secret Outlast Clear Gel.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
This is Pete. Pete is helping his aunt move, so he's not thinking about tires right now. But if he were, all he'd need to know is TireRack.com. Right now, he can get a $70 Visa prepaid card when he buys a set of four select Bridgestone tires. For details, he'd go to TireRack.com/Bridgestone offer. But Pete's not thinking about tires. Pete's thinking it would have been nice if his aunt had mentioned the Minor Bird. TireRack.com. Find, deliver, install.
We spend much of the day on our feet. Why not do it comfortably? Come to Noble Shoes and discover a huge variety of shoes and immerse yourself in a new level of comfort. We carry the best names in comfort footwear in the world. Wherever your day takes you, we have the right shoe for you. Noble Shoes, Northlake Boulevard and Military Trail in Palm Beach Gardens.
It makes me happy to go on the computer. I like feeling smart.
Internet Essentials from Comcast has brought low-cost internet access to over 1.4 million low-income people at home.
Internet Essentials helped me progress in my schoolwork. It helped my grades move higher.
Today, it's the largest broadband adoption program in America.
It helped me a lot.
Comcast NBC Universal, helping to bridge the digital divide.
You just never know what's going to happen.
Well, we're talking about severe weather today, but we still have winter weather, believe it or not. It is your time now for the full winter weather update here in the lab. Dr. Greg Postel, and yes, it's still snowing.
I know, snow's moving through Duluth right now, and of course, the UP of Michigan. Marquette has snow moving through now, but they often have snow in late May.
Sure.
I think their last date of average measurable snow is in the latter third of May.
Certainly not unheard of to get snow this time of year, although for some, it might be insult to injury, although this is not one of those parts of the country. It's been kind of quiet in the Midwest for snow this year.
Yeah, it has. They haven't seen a lot. In fact, I have some relatives up in northern Minnesota that say they've seen very little snow. And actually, this winter was much less severe than last year's in Minnesota. But anyway, let's go to Pennsylvania now because we have some freezing rain to talk about.
Yeah, and you can actually pick out the topography of the land right now because you're seeing where, you know, where the radar algorithm is saying rain versus freezing rain.
Yeah, and those colder valleys, it looks like that there's still a threat for freezing rain across central Pennsylvania, probably for the next couple of hours. As the whole big giant weather system that's associated with it, it's not real strong, but moves through the upper Midwest and Great Lakes. And we're going to get some snow probably through early morning hours or so.
Now, we will get flow around those lows eventually, and then the lakes can get involved and kind of enhance some of that snowfall as well.
Yeah, I mean, we're going as much as 3 to 5 in parts, but really not more than that. I mean, it's beginning to wind down. You get the sense that winter is on its last legs, at least across the upper Midwest. But tomorrow, there could be some rain and snow mix moving through Detroit and then getting farther to the east across New York, Pennsylvania, and parts of New England.
So an interior New England snow event to the coast, certainly warm enough for rain.
Think so. That's right. How often have we heard Boston rain in the last 4 or 5 months? Yeah, so it's not been very often. But yes, as you said, interior New England and the Northeast, probably more winter rather than wet.
But the cold air is still sticking around. I mean, that was one thing that really is evident around those areas of low pressure. You get the north wind again, especially compared to average. It's going to be really chilly.
Pretty high amplitude jet stream, Mark, coming across parts of North America. And that big dip in the east is going to be associated with some pretty chilly air
That's not going to stop once it gets to even the Gulf Coast. It's going to all the way through Central and South Florida, probably. Highs there on Saturday, 15 to 25 degrees below average. But look at some of these numbers on Sunday morning. 32 in Atlanta, 42 in Jacksonville.
Yeah, and the growing season has begun. Tennessee to Alabama to Georgia. So that is a problem when you start to get temps below or near freezing. Viv, over to you.
All right, thanks very much, guys. Well, you know, for the second day in a row, Springfield, Missouri is at risk for severe storms. Now, the storms are just one cause for concern. Our own Keith Carson is in Springfield, and he highlights another big threat for that region.
Well, here in Springfield, Missouri, another day with possible severe weather after what's been a really quiet month so far, not only here, but nationwide as far as severe went. Yesterday was interesting because we had some elevated storms. There was some rotation in them. We got some video of that, of the storms kind of rotating around. Looked like a pretty good wall cloud. Typically, you want to take shelter when you see one of those, but they were very, very high in the atmosphere. Never got a chance to create funnel clouds or certainly get down to the ground itself. So we'll be watching to see if that continues again today. But something that has changed compared to yesterday is that today we have a flash flood threat. The reason for that is the warm front is parked right over us. Storms may train, go over the same areas over and over again. So even if they're not severe, and likely not all of them will be, they'll be dropping some heavy downpours in one place over and over again. 2 to 3 inches of rain is a possibility. So that flash flood watch issued by the National Weather Service will be valid tonight through early tomorrow morning. Even when the severe weather risk dies down later tonight, we'll still be watching the flooding concerns as this system moves out. After that, things cool down in a big way later on in the week. Back to you.
All right. Thanks very much, Keith. Let's check on the threat of severe weather today. Here's a look at the latest imagery. Actually, we have this radar, which does show the storms developing over the southeastern parts of Kansas. And as we hone in a little bit closer, you can see just to the north and west of Independence, Kansas, we have that particular thunderstorm cell. It has already produced golf ball size hailstones, winds over 50 miles per hour. And as you can see, it's continuing to move off to the north and east. So we'll continue to follow this. Watch out if you're in its path. Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Thursday, thunderstorms. High 86. Chance of rain 80%. Here's our 7-day outlook. On Weather Center Live, we're tracking another round of severe weather. About 10 million people are at risk today for storms that could produce more of this. Large hailstones, damaging winds, and even a greater threat of tornadoes today. We're timing it all for you, city by city.
And unfortunately, we still can't say it ain't snow because the white stuff is still falling. We're talking about the wintry side to this spring storm. It's all part of an extreme pattern that we have to tell you about. It is affecting millions of you. Our expert-filled in-depth live coverage starts right here, right now on Weather Center Live.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Vivian Brown.
And I'm Mark Elliott. And Viv, we are in spring, and we've got all types of weather to talk about. A winter that won't quit, and a severe side.
Yes, spring did not spring, really, until just yesterday. But we're off to a slow start, but definitely making up for time because those storms are starting to ramp up.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, check this out. We are looking at a hail storm behind us. My goodness, a real clear evidence of that nasty weather that we had.
Mm-hmm. Hailstones, high winds, another threat today, even the threat of tornadoes. You can see the hailstones covering the ground there. Hail range to the size of peas to even up to quarter size inch hailstones. And we even had parts of southwestern Missouri again today, the target region for the severe weather. So we're watching this entire red zone. Here's Mark with more.
Yeah, you know, let's start out with what happened yesterday. If we know what happened yesterday, we have a better job at knowing what's going to happen today, because it is a similar area and a similar setup to yesterday. So at this time yesterday, we were watching storms getting going. As we put this map into motion here, we had some individual storm cells that then came together as a line, a pretty powerful line of storms, southern Missouri into Arkansas. We're already seeing storms getting organized today in many of these same areas. Now, yesterday, it was all about hail and wind threats, over 70 storm reports. And we want to go out to the lab now because Dr. Greg Postel, he's monitoring the storms that are going on today, and we're already getting hail reports.
Yeah, we are in southern Kansas, Mark. There's a batch of thunderstorms right along a warm front that's moving north at about 30 miles per hour and is now associated with thunderstorms producing hail. Let's go and look at the satellite pictures right now because you can see exactly where that is. Right here, guys, I can highlight it right on the satellite picture combined with the radar between Wichita and Springfield in the southeast corner of Kansas. Let's look at that. We have a severe thunderstorm warning out for Elk, Montgomery, and Wilson counties in Kansas until 12:45 p.m. Central Time. These storms, again, are moving northeast at about 35 and have had a history of producing some hail, bigger than quarter-sized hails that has actually done some damage in some places. So let's have a look at this hail tracker, which we've got moving out of southern Kansas just to the northwest of Independence. And the radar is estimating hail sizes up to 2 inches. And that is close to some of the observed sizes that we've seen on the ground. Overall, in the bigger view, this is where those thunderstorms occurring right along that warm front where there's a lot of surface convergence. Airflow is coming out of the south over here and out northeast over here. And that air is being forced upward right near that warm front and helping to initiate those thunderstorms. Later on today, we're going to watch for the new development not far from this dry line here, separating very moist air out here and dry air behind there. That dry line will help initiate storms as it moves on off toward the east, northeast across parts of Oklahoma, I would say by about 3 or 4 o'clock. This is the area that we have at risk for severe weather today. Primary hazards are large hail, which we've already seen, some high winds, and the possibility of tornadoes. Let's look at the ingredients now individually and sort of assess what the risk of the relative risk of the severe weather types is. We've got pretty high available energy forecasts later on this afternoon across this zone of Oklahoma and North Texas and Western Arkansas. We also have a pretty decent amount of wind shear. That means a turning and increase in speed of wind with height. At the surface, we got the wind flow about like that. And aloft, the wind flow is out of a different direction and will be increasing in speed with height. So we'll get kind of a rolling motion in the atmosphere that will be tapped by some of those thunderstorms that will help them rotate and last a little bit longer than they would otherwise. So when you combine the instability and the shear together, the overlap area is right in here. This is the outlined area for the highest instability, and there's the shear and where they overlap. We think the greatest risk for tornadoes would be today. And we have a Torcon value of 4 across this region, which is a 40% chance of seeing a tornado within 50 miles of a point all the way from southwest Missouri and parts of northeastern Oklahoma. Timing it out across the region, there are those thunderstorms along that warm front that could become severe and have been already with likely hail producing thunderstorms. And then right here along that dry line, watch out across parts of central and eastern Oklahoma through the evening hours for storms that the chance of producing a tornado or two. Stay tuned for all the latest. Could be an active day ahead. Guys, back to you.
Southwest Missouri is in the bullseye when it comes to today's storm threat. So joining us now is David Gady with the National Weather Service office out of Springfield, Missouri. Now, David, thanks for joining us. Well, we've already seen some thunderstorm warnings across parts of Arkansas for sure. Are you surprised that the storms are firing up already so early in the afternoon?
No, not really. Mm-hmm. Down there in the warm sector, we would expect thunderstorms to be developing at this time here. Up here in southwest Missouri, we're kind of looking for mid to late afternoon for our severe thunderstorms to develop.
Yes, we're already beginning to see some of the ingredients come together for some parts. Let's talk more about the gusty winds and the hailstones that you saw yesterday. What did you see as the biggest threats yesterday?
Well, yesterday it was predominantly hail. We were getting reports of hail up to an inch and a half in diameter. We did get a couple of reports of some wind damage, but most of the damage was, most of the reports were from hail.
Yeah, an inch and a half, that's at least a little bit larger than quarters, and those winds were up to at least 50, 55 miles per hour?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, this season is getting underway, you know, a bit later than it does on average. Does that surprise you?
Well, no, not really. Mm-hmm. I mean, this time of year, the weather here in southwest Missouri normally gears up about this time of year.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks very much. That is David Gady with the National Weather Service office out of Springfield, Missouri. Of course, in the target area for severe weather today, and we will keep you updated as the watches and warnings are issued throughout the afternoon.
And Viv, you know, we talk about Torcon as a way to gauge a tornado risk that you might have in a particular town. It's a tool developed by our own severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes, the Tornado Condition Index, or Torcon. Here's what it means, right? If you have a 3 on your Torcon scale, you multiply that by 10. It means a 30% chance of seeing a tornado within that 50-mile radius surrounding the point. Many of you are under Torcon scales of 3 or 4 today. There is that threat, Viv, so we'll watch it carefully.
All right. Thanks very much, Mark. Well, this spring storm is cranking out more than severe weather. There's a wintry side of it as well. We'll talk more about the snow and the cold air that we find not only in Bayfield. But
I'll ride the highway. I'm going my way. I leave a story untold.
He just keeps sending more pictures.
If you're a free-range chicken, you roam free. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to GEICO. It's what you do.
Incredible. I've been Claritin clear for 10 days.
When your allergy symptoms start, doctors recommend taking one Claritin every day of your allergy season for continuous relief.
With powerful 24-hour non-drowsy Claritin, live Claritin clear. Every day.
The FDA issued a public notice to doctors and patients concerning serious injuries caused by transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, and bladder sling. Please call now if you had one of these devices implanted in the last 5 years. You may be entitled to a cash award. If you had a transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, or bladder sling in the last 5 years,
please call 1-866-686-7952 now.
This is my story.
This is my journey.
This is the future of the gang.
We are going to Augusta National.
The Drive, Chip, and Putt National Finals. April 5th at 8 a.m. Eastern on Golf Channel.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 72. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 86, chance of rain 80%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Sundays.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Success starts with the right connections. Introducing Miracle-Gro Liquifeed Universal Feeder. Turn any hose connection into a clever feeding system for a well-fed garden. Miracle-Gro. Life starts here.
Going to the paint studio at Ace is like going to your neighbor. And hurry in this Wednesday through Sunday for buy 1 gallon, get one free. Save up to $71 when you buy 2 gallons, exclusively at Ace.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
set the world in motion. The full line of Ram ProMaster vans. And the all-new Ram ProMaster City. Purpose-built to help you run the town. Ram.
We are following the threat of severe weather today in the heart of the country, but still dealing with winter here across the Great Lakes. You're looking across the Upper Peninsula of Michigan in the Marquette area where the temperature is below freezing. You can see it's still snowing very lightly. We have about a couple of inches on the ground since 24 hours ago. So winter is definitely trying to hang on. More spring snow. Yes, that's what we have to tell you about as we watch another little disturbance kind of swing through. Again, this is the Marquette area. Notice the snow is coming to an end, but again, this very batch dumped about 2 inches across the region, and we're noticing some wintry weather slowly but surely trying to exit the northern parts of the lower peninsula too, and then some chilly rain been indicated by the green as it slides across the western parts of New York and west to central Pennsylvania. So two distinct areas of low pressure. Both of them will be moving off to the east. We think this one will really be the reinforcing system that will let us know that winter is still hanging around with that colder air and a little bit of snow kind of clipping the northern parts here. In fact, along with the cold front, say tomorrow we'll watch a narrow band of wintry weather kind of slide to the east of the Great Lakes as they push into the western parts of New York and Pennsylvania. So generally speaking, 1 to 3 inch accumulations, more or less than that, closer to the 1 inch than the 3 inches, but nonetheless, it's springtime officially, and we're still talking snow. Here's a look at the official forecast for you in Duluth as we're anticipating a couple of more hours of all snow, but then starting to mix in with some chilly rain and then just give way to basically cloudy conditions with temperatures in the upper 30s later on. And Berlin, New Hampshire, well, there you see the air will be cold enough, we think, in all layers of the atmosphere to produce the snow. It'll be a wet snow, though, with the temperatures at about 9 o'clock this evening, just a little bit above the freezing mark. Notice the temperature will stay steady at about 34 degrees right on into the midnight hour in Berlin and New Hampshire, but maybe an additional inch or two before all is said and done. Again, the bottom line is that we do have cold air in place, and where the moisture is falling into that cold air, still the chances of some light snow. Back to you, Mark.
All right, Viv, want to let you know about some severe storms in Kansas and Missouri. We'll get to those warnings in just a second, so don't tune away if you are trying to get information on those. There is some rain in the Northeast that we're talking about as well, though. Detroit, Philly, D.C. all socked in the clouds. It is a soggy setup for you. The stormy setup from the Ozarks is now sheared out across the Northeast and the Midwest, and that's why you're seeing this rain. So let's go into the rainy side of things for now, as we are still dealing with a wet start or wet go through the week, but a warm up across the east as well. Here's that warm front. It is chugging its way throughout New England. The cold air is still in the valleys of Pennsylvania, so a little bit of freezing rain being indicated. It's pretty cool that you can pick out the topography by the radar itself. But yes, it's all about this warm front, which moves through the day, and that rain and maybe even some snow will move through as well. But the warm air is key here. We're going to see that subtly flow, increasing the heat, but also increasing the moisture. It will start to feel muggy and sticky across the east. New area of low pressure and strong cold front comes in for the end of the week. That's what then it basically instigates the rainy setup and lifts all that moisture up into the air. So for today, still in the 40s, but look at tomorrow, 61 in New York, 70 in Philly, 75 in D.C. out ahead of the cold front. Viv, that rain is still coming in.
All right. Thanks, Mark. Well, we have a question for you. What do these two cities have in common? Phoenix, Arizona, Charleston, South Carolina. It's more than the fact that they're both in the southern half of the nation. We'll share the answer with you as Weather Center Live rolls on.
It may seem strange, but people really can love their laxative, especially when it's Miralax. It hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock your system naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative. Miralax.
Do you take your eyes off the road when you get a phone call? Or when you take a turn, does your phone take a fall? Then you need the incredible Clever Grip by Bell & Howell. The new smartphone clip with a super strong grip. No more fumbling for your phone and looking away from the road. Clever Grip holds your phone at eye level without blocking your vision. And the 360-degree pivoting head rotates for easy viewing. Perfect for driving with GPS.
Take next left.
Streaming your music.
Hello?
Or hands-free calling.
I'm using my new Clever Grip.
Clever Grip fits any style air vent, and the spring-loaded clamp holds everything tight, from the smallest flip phones to the largest smartphone. Those other mounts obstruct your vision, are hard to reach, and eventually lose suction. They never hold. But Clever Grip mounts at the perfect height, just like your car's most important gauges. You get a clear view of the road and easy access to all your phone's functions. Even this heavy brick is no match for Clever Grip. It works with your favorite phone cases and those bulky battery packs. It's great for passengers watching videos. And Clever Grip goes from the car to the house. And now you have an instant stand in the palm of your hand. It's the ideal stand for people who travel. It's the portable clip with the amazing grip. Call and order your Clever Grip by Bell & Howell today for just $14.95. Available only through this special TV offer. But wait, if you call right now, we'll give you a second Clever Grip free. Just pay separate processing. Perfect for every driver in the family. We guarantee you'll love it or your money back. So don't delay. Get Clever Grip today.
To get your Clever Grip for only $14.95 and get a second one free, call 1-800-549-0620 or go to buycleverGrip.com. That's 1-800-549-0620. Order yours today.
But now, let's put this out here.
I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
I am the luckiest woman in the world because I was one of the first people to sail on Bahamas Paradise Cruise Line's beautiful Grand Celebration, the newest cruise to the Bahamas and by far the best cruise ship to ever sail from the Port of Palm Beach. With two nights on the ship, great food, lots of pampering, a spectacular day in the Bahamas, and prices from just $149, you can get lucky too by calling 800-814-7100 today. I had so much fun that the next time I take a two-night cruise, I'm going to add a two-night stay in the Bahamas at a beautiful resort with soft white sand beaches and crystal clear water. This four-night Bahamas cruise and resort stay package is the best vacation value anywhere. So what are you waiting for? Call 800-814-7100. That's 800-814-7100. And let the fun begin.
Sundays.
One man's trash
did the work.
Is another man's totally awesome beer can space heater.
Hi.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Stay tuned for your Local on the 8 brought to you by Duracell, trusted to outlast the storm.
I've seen hurricanes, floods, I've seen tornadoes. We give out Duracell batteries after the worst happens. And when the power's out for days, we stay with them. You might say they lost everything, but that's not what I see. I see a different kind of power. I saw it in Ruth, Adam, Tom. It's the power they have inside of them. The power to move forward.
At Duracell, we believe that's the power that never, ever goes out.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 72. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 86, chance of rain 80%. here's our 7-day outlook.
Tale of two cities, or really a tale of two halves of the country. Right now you're looking live. Atlanta's on the right side of your screen. You know, overcast skies, it's kind of dark and drizzly. How about Vegas? Nothing but clear blue, the heat and the drought continuing. You could say the same thing between Phoenix and Charleston. Yeah, they are prime examples of this extreme weather pattern that will set up through the week and has been set up across the country. It's very hot, it's very dry out west. It is cool and unsettled in the east. Viv, let's talk about this extreme weather setup.
Yes, talk about two halves of the country. The jet stream tells all. In fact, it creates a big trough of low pressure over the eastern half of the country. But across the west, the jet stream is pushing all the way into Canada, creating a huge ridge of high pressure. Now, that high pressure responsible for a lot of hot air that we have, in particular over the southwest, but the entire western half of the country. Afternoon highs running above average. So there you have it, that cooler pool of air over the east with the jet stream taking a dive, allowing all the cold air from Canada, the Northwest Territories, even from the Arctic, to push south of the border. Of course, modifying a little bit, but the overall trend is that we'll find cooler conditions over the east and much, much warmer conditions across the west, to the tune of 15 to 25 degrees above or below average. In fact, here's a look at the particulars on Friday. Afternoon highs only in the low 60s, say Atlanta, but guess what? It's even colder. Colder on Saturday, not getting out of the low 50s. That's a good 15 degrees below average. Now, Saturday morning, dropping down to the mid 30s. But Sunday morning, literally, we'll be freezing perhaps at 32 degrees Fahrenheit when we wake up in Atlanta. So please be prepared for that little cold start to the Sunday coming up. Okay, just the opposite across the west as you turn the coin on the other side. You talk about the offshore winds, possibly some record highs on Saturday in Las Vegas, up to 91 degrees, 92 actually, and in Los Angeles, even tomorrow, 91. So again, hot across the west, but cool over the east. Back to you, Mark.
Thanks, Viv. Now, in between, we have the clash of those two air masses, right? In part of the heartland, it's day two of severe weather and what could be the most widespread severe weather threat in months. We've got the zone up for today from North Texas all the way up to southern Missouri. And we're talking about this zone for hail and wind threats, but an isolated tornado threat as well. A 4 on the Torcon scale from southwest Missouri to northwest Arkansas to northeastern Oklahoma. That means a 40% chance of seeing a tornado within any 50-mile radius within this zone. And some big cities are at play here, right? Oklahoma City, a 4, starting at about 4 o'clock, going till 10. Springfield, Missouri, a 4 as well, starting at 2, so a little bit earlier there. Later in the evening, Paducah, Kentucky, you have a 3 on the Torcon scale, and hail and wind can be featured in all of these. Let's put this radar into motion. Watch what happens along the I-44 corridor by about the drive home time, 4, 5 o'clock. The storm's really blossom there along I-44. We could have some problems with that. We'll continue to roll this right on through the evening hours as well. 8 o'clock, we could see some of those big storms rolling by also. And so not only are we talking hail, but we're also talking about wind damage with these storms. And the kind of winds that can cause as much damage as a tornado at times, especially when the winds, even straight line winds, get strong. At 45 to 57 miles per hour, trees will start to bend, small limbs will break, but then the winds get stronger. Trees can start to fall, especially the shallow rooted trees at 58 to 74 miles per hour. And even semi-trucks have trouble with those winds. They have such a wide face with the truck itself that they can get blown over. And when winds get severe, up to 90 miles per hour, widespread tree damage, roof damage, weak structures may even fall. We've got to follow all of this today, the severe threat.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn. Don't let a severe cold hold you back.
Theraflu medicine breaks you free from your worst cold and flu symptoms. It has the power of three medicines to take on your worst pain and fever, cough, and nasal congestion.
Okay, guys, it's getting late. You gotta hit the road.
Millions of people count on the Weather Channel.
Good morning, guys. Let's get the live shot set up.
That's why the Weather Channel counts on Theraflu products. Theraflu, serious power.
Hey, buddy, you're squashing me. Liquid wart remover could take weeks to treat.
Embarrassing wart? Dr. Scholl's Freeze-Away wipes them out fast with as few as one treatment.
Freeze-Away!
Dr. Scholl's, the number one selling freeze brand.
You know, some people have told me reverse mortgages sound too good to be true. I mean, you get cash out of your home, no monthly payments, and still own your home. There's got to be a catch, right, Jesse?
Well, there isn't. It's like any other mortgage, only with a reverse mortgage, the loan's paid back when the last borrower leaves the home. In fact, reverse mortgages are based on a notion that President Reagan signed into law over 25 years ago in order to help seniors remain in their homes. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you may qualify for a government-insured reverse mortgage with AAG that allows you to turn the equity in your home into tax-free cash. And with AAG, there are never any credit score requirements.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive a new free information kit, including a reverse mortgage guide and DVD, personal stories from people like you, and a brand new family guide for children and loved ones, all absolutely free with no obligation.
AAG can help you pay off credit card debt, eliminate monthly mortgage payments, and provide some real retirement security.
Call 1-800-661-0312 today to get your free AAG reverse mortgage information kit and bonus DVD.
In the kit, you'll receive a helpful three-part guide. The first will show you how a government-insured reverse mortgage allows you to access the equity in your home as tax-free cash. 500,000 people have already done it. The second booklet contains stories told by people just like you who've had their lives changed forever using a reverse mortgage. And the third guide is full of helpful answers and information for children and loved ones.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free.
They're simply an effective way for folks just like you to get the cash you need to enjoy your retirement.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free. Call 1-800-661-0312 now.
AAG, the best advice for a better life.
But now, let's put this out here.
I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 72. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 86, chance of rain 80%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
The severe weather threat is starting to ramp up. Thanks so much for sticking with us here on Weather Center Live. I'm Mark Elliott.
And I'm Vivian Brown. When you're dealing with severe weather, it can be very dangerous and scary. There's not just one element, though. We could have hailstones, dangerous winds, and even tornadoes today.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, some of the same areas that saw severe weather from last night into today.
Here's a look at the radar from yesterday. Right around 4 o'clock, that's when we began to see the very beginning signs of the severe weather. You see the yellows, the reds there in southeastern Kansas, southwestern Missouri. That was about 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon. And as we passed through, say, 2 hours, right at 6 o'clock, notice how that area extended, and we have some stronger storms that pushed closer to the Springfield area. And right around 8 o'clock, it started to die down a little bit, but this could be repeated today.
And one of the biggest threats today will be hail. And it seems kind of hard to believe that hail so big can stay up in the sky before falling down to us here on the ground. But that's exactly what occurs. This is our hail size comparison chart. And look down at the bottom of your chart. You can see those wind speeds. Those are measures of the needed updrafts in the storm, that wind moving up and away from the earth and up through the cloud to hold the size of hail. Pea-sized hail can be held up with an updraft of about 35 miles per hour, but we've had already reports today of quarter to golf ball size hail, which requires anywhere from about 50 to 65 mile per hour winds in those updrafts. And in the past, we've had hail reports significantly larger than that, up to baseball or even softball size hail, and that as well needs stronger and stronger updrafts, and that potential is there today, Viv, for some nasty storms with some large hail.
And those large hailstones can create quite a bit of damage. So let's bring in our storm specialist, Dr. Greg Postel. He's going to tell us what he's looking at right now in terms of the radar and the upper level charts to give us a precise look at the changes in the atmosphere. Dr. Postel, what do you see right now?
Viv, thank you very much. Hailers right now across parts of southern Kansas, thunderstorms that are producing some hail, perhaps up to golf ball size. Let's go to the charts and I can show you. There it is, just north of the Oklahoma border, right in here. This cluster of storms, there's some convergence there at low levels helping to lift the atmosphere a little bit and trigger the thunderstorm development. The zone from Wichita on eastward over to Springfield, Missouri, not too far away from Joplin. Let's go through some of these warnings. Montgomery and Wilson counties in Kansas until 12:45 p.m. Then we've got another warning just to its east for Neosho and Wilson counties in Kansas. And over on the Missouri side, just to the northeast of Joplin, we have Dade, Jasper, and Lawrence counties in Missouri until 1 o'clock. And these are all for the possibility of golf ball size hail and wind gusts up to 60 miles per hour, also here in Greene and Lawrence counties in Missouri. So let's have a look at some of the hail sizes in here. According to our hail tracks on the radar, you can see these hail tracks moving off toward the northeast. Again, the speed is about 35 miles per hour, and there have been reports of at least quarter-sized hail with some of these storms. So if you live in these locations near Reed or perhaps Mount Vernon, maybe even in the Springfield area or just to the west of there in the next hour or so, some of these hail storms will be moving through that could do damage to automobiles. And we've seen that already farther to the west across parts of Kansas with the hailstorms out there with 1.5 inch hail doing damage to the roofs of cars. So that's the kind of damage that you can expect with these hailers right now across parts of southern Kansas. Those again are forming along a warm front where there is a bit of convergence here. In fact, the air is coming out of the south. It's pretty warm and humid like that. Not quite as warm and humid with an airflow coming out of the northeast just north of that boundary. That's why we're seeing those thunderstorms erupt right in that contrast of air masses there. So this is an area to watch for the next several hours. Also, we're going to be watching for the development of new thunderstorms right here along and just ahead of that dry line as it moves that direction, where the air right now is clear, it's heating up, and it's pretty humid across parts of south central Oklahoma. So big storms in about, I would say, 3 to 4 hours. Watch out for convective initiation across that zone later on this afternoon. Primary hazards even there will be large hail and damaging winds, but the threat of tornadoes does exist, at least through the early nighttime hours. There's the whole widespread region there that we expect the possibility of severe weather. Now let's break down the ingredients real quickly here, showing you that the area of the highest available energy for the storms is that area shaded in yellow. So this is the amount of energy that the storms used to grow tall and strong, and that's where it's most or the highest levels there. We've also got a decent amount of wind shear, which means we have a change in wind direction and an increase in wind speed with height of the wind flow. So the surface winds are doing that across that zone where the instability is pretty high, but yet at about 10,000 feet, they're out of a different direction and they get strong pretty quickly. So you get a sense that there's some rolling motion ongoing already present in the atmosphere. So when those thunderstorms use that instability to grow tall, you know, they'll rotate as those updrafts acquire that wind shear, ingest that wind shear. And there you can see the overlap of where the wind shear is strongest there, where the instability is the strongest. See that zone right in here? Watch out for the possibility of some pretty big storms in a couple of hours. As a result of that, we've got torcons as high as 4 across the region, 40% chance of a tornado within 50 miles of a location. Let's time it out across parts of the region. We see, I think, the development of thunderstorms along that bulging dry line moving through Oklahoma City by about 5 or 6 o'clock. And here's the warm funnel stuff on the I-44 corridor from Tulsa to Springfield, Missouri. And the storms keep rolling on as we go through the late evening and our early nighttime hours. Guys, stay tuned. It could be a long day ahead. Back to you.
All right. Thanks very much, Dr. Postel. Now, that red zone did include parts of Texas. In fact, in North Texas, emergency managers are making last-minute checks to make sure the public is prepared and informed ahead of the storms.
Yeah, Chris Van Horn from affiliate KXAS takes a look at the steps officials are taking after a number of outdoor warning sirens malfunctioned in recent months.
The skies are clear, but the Texas winds are whipping. As the first chance for severe weather approaches, those whose job it is to make sure the public is warned are ready as they check and fix warning sirens like this one on West Bonds Ranch Road in far north Fort Worth. No siren test today, but nearby resident Destiny Anderson is glad to know it's working whenever the next emergency or test happens.
It's a good time to teach the kids what to do in case of a tornado, and we normally keep our TV on and teach them the safe spots in the house.
Right now, the city says two of its 149 sirens are currently out of service, and that's why they want people to continue to sign up for text alerts.
The best way of receiving the initial warning is still the outdoor warning system, but to find out more detailed information, you need to be connected.
The text warnings don't just inform residents of what's on the horizon, but if a problem in the system occurs, like 6 months ago when several sirens malfunctioned.
We don't expect those problems to happen again.
But water, wind, and lightning can still cause issues, so whether it's a false alarm or something real, Ortiz says it's best to sign up, be informed, and stay prepared.
It just takes one storm to really cause a lot of damage.
As a familiar sound of spring is ready to go. Fort Worth, Chris Van Horn, NBC5.
Making sure you are aware, that's our number one job here, is to make sure that you're weather ready at all times.
Yeah, that especially holds true for today, as we do have that risk of severe weather, including tornadoes. So let's go through some advice to keep you and your family safe in a tornado warning. And start things out if you're in a mobile home, and the best advice here is to just get out. Most tornadoes can destroy even tied down mobile homes. You need to get to the nearest sturdy permanent building as soon as possible.
Now, if you're in your car, if you can, it's best to get out and run quickly to a sturdy building. Do not try to shelter under a bridge or an overpass. Now, if you cannot get out of your car in time, drive out of the tornado's path by moving at right angles to the tornado.
And if you're in an office building, like a lot of us are today, go to the center of the building, an enclosed windowless area in the center of the building on the lowest floor that you can get to. Interior stairwells are usually good places to take shelter, and you might have to use that today. Watching severe weather next.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, considerable cloudiness, slight chance of a rain shower. High 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 72. Thursday, scattered thunderstorms. High 85, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
You drop 40 grand on a new set of wheels, then wham, a minivan T-bones you. Guess what? Your insurance company will only give you $37,000 to replace it. Depreciation, they claim. How can my car depreciate before its first oil change, you ask? Maybe the better question is, why do you have that insurance company?
With Liberty Mutual new car replacement, we'll replace the full value of your car. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Success starts with the right connections. Introducing Miracle-Gro Liquifeed Universal Feeder. Turn any hose connection into a clever feeding system for a well-fed garden. Miracle-Gro. Life starts here.
Sometimes, bigger is better. But other times, bigger just gets in the way. At Brother, we know the biggest printer isn't always the best fit for every office. So we've come up with a bigger idea. Don't supersize, optimize. See how we can help you put the right printers in all the right places and help reduce your costs. Now that's big. Brother, at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
We're here today asking kids what their favorite vegetable is.
Kids?
Now we're going to give those same kids Bush's Baked Beans.
Bush's Baked Beans, the vegetable that kids love.
Heartburn.
Did someone say burn? Try Alka-Seltzer Relief Chews. They work just as fast and are proven to taste better than Tums Smoothies Assorted Fruit.
Amazing.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. Enjoy the relief.
Supermodel Cindy Crawford doesn't just walk the red carpet, she rocks it. At age 47, she steals the show and wows the international press. New York Daily News raves that Cindy defies the laws of aging. And Us Weekly proclaims Cindy Crawford hasn't aged a bit. Her secret is Meaningful Beauty, a complete skincare system that restores the look of youth.
My skin looks firmer now. It's smooth and it's young looking. I'm so glad I found Meaningful Beauty.
Since using Meaningful Beauty, my skin tone is evening out. And I notice that all the little lines have softened. My skin has never looked better.
And right now is the perfect time for you to experience Meaningful Beauty, because this brand new offer is Cindy's best deal ever. Normally $119, you'll pay only $39.95 when you call and order today. But hold on, this is where the offer gets really good. Cindy's Red Carpet Trio, a $95 value, is yours absolutely free when you call now. The trio includes two Meaningful Beauty favorites, Wrinkle Smoothing Capsules and Glowing Serum, for an immediate boost of glamour and glow. And when you order today, you also get the amazing Skin Polishing Brush. This two-speed, ultra-luxurious brush gently but deeply cleanses, powering away dry, dead skin cells, revealing smoother, more radiant-looking skin.
The brush really feels like it's polishing my skin, and it just leaves it with an incredible glow.
The total effect of this free gift package? A red carpet-ready complexion. You get all this, a $215 value, for just $39.95. But you must act quickly. Results guaranteed or your money back.
Pick up the phone. Try it. It's going to make you feel beautiful. You're going to be thrilled.
This is a limited-time offer, so call 1-800-530-3933 or go to trymb.com/brush now.
Well, my mom and dad have one, and you'll hear it. You'll hear it, and you'll know where to go, and it tells you, I believe they tell you where it's at, how many minutes away.
Warnings save lives. Outside sirens are fine, but when you're inside, the way the houses are built nowadays, you can't hear it. And so by having the radio, it takes care of that.
And as the severe season really ramps up, groups like the Salvation Army are trying to get residents in Pilgrim, Nebraska weather ready for this year. That's the alert that you would hear if you had that radio. They were deeply affected by last year's deadly tornadoes.
Yeah, residents received free weather radios just yesterday. And along with the weather radios, the group also handed out emergency disaster go bags at the event. That's very nice.
Yeah.
Now, you know, no other weather phenomenon can match the power and destruction of tornadoes. Sustained winds can tear apart buildings and toss trucks like toothpicks.
Yeah, but as severe weather expert Dr. Greg Forbes explains, it's actually a second force that comes into play that impresses him the most.
It's amazing to see some of the things that a tornado can do. Maybe it shouldn't surprise us, considering that some tornadoes can have horizontal winds over 200 miles per hour and extremely strong updrafts that can pick things up. One of the things that we see a lot are tractor trailers that get tossed about. At about 15 tons empty, that's pretty impressive. Let's freeze this, and I'll talk about how this happens. The tractor trailer is heavy, but it has a lot of surface. It's about 70 feet long, 13 to 14 feet high. That's a lot of area for the winds to blow against, and some of the tornado winds can get underneath. They can go upwards 100 miles per hour, lift up the tractor trailer, even make it fly. Now I'm going to show you something not as big, not as heavy, but I consider even more impressive. Look at these parking blocks. They weigh 300 pounds, and it's hard to imagine how the wind can get under them. It must take winds that are extremely strong, just within inches of the ground, to be able to begin to roll these, and then it can pick them up and toss them through the air. In most tornadoes, we think the fastest winds are really about 50 feet above ground. Blocks like these got tossed up to 50 yards. Finally, let me show you something that I consider even more incredible. Some tornadoes have even been known to scour soil right out of the ground. It's hard to understand how that could happen. You can reach down and try to pull some out with your hands, but you'll just tear up some grass. It's difficult even enough to shovel soil out of the ground. We even saw dirt get pulled out of the ground in the EF5 Smithville, Mississippi tornado back on April 27, 2011. Maybe a trench up to the width of a football field and 2 feet deep. It even tore asphalt out of a roadway surface. How do we think this can happen? A combination of wind force and pressure force. Wind force, winds unusually low right down to the ground to push on the soil, while there's a pressure force, maybe a moisture layer underneath that got vaporized pushing upward, while low pressure in the tornado pulled upward and popped the sod right out of the ground.
All right, talk about some impressive stuff. Here's a look at the setup today as we look for severe weather. This is the warm front. To the south of it is where we have the warmest air. And actually, that warm air is overriding slightly cooler air. And that's where we have some thunderstorms developing as we speak in southeastern Kansas. This is a closer look at those thunderstorms. This is Chanute, Kansas. And just to the north of Independence, crossing right through the Chanute area, we do have some severe storms. We have had reports of at least quarter-sized hailstones, even some hailstones up to the size of baseballs. And just to the east of Chanute, as we cross over into southwestern Missouri, we're beginning to see some storms develop just to the west of Springfield. Pretty much some of the same areas that we were dealing with this time yesterday with the most severe weather. There's a severe thunderstorm warning for Greene and Lawrence counties as these storms are moving to the east and northeast. Again, with a history of hailstones and very gusty winds, winds have been clocked over 50 miles per hour with some of these storms already. Here's a look at the hail trackers now. Look at these particular storms as they moved out of the Chanute area off to the north and east. Again, at least the size of quarters, if not even golf ball size hailstones. Again, 1.5 inch. That's between a quarter and a golf ball. So some pretty impressive hailstones we've already had from these storms. So this is the outlook for today, looking at this whole area as we go deeper into the afternoon for the severe weather. We will be here tracking them for you.
When it comes to losing weight, everyone has a number. And if you want to get your performance back and feel great, do what I did. One call and I lost it all. 22 pounds gone.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
Nutrisystem has everything you need to feel better, look better, and perform better at any age, faster than ever before.
I haven't felt this good in years. Thank you, Nutrisystem. I lost 8 pounds in the first week.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes and craving crusher shakes, free. New food selections, new expert guides. Call now and lock in 2014 prices, and shipping is free.
Whether your number's 10 or 50, make the right call. Nutrisystem.
Call 855-789-THIN now and lose your first 5 pounds fast.
Gonna go fast. Hold on.
You just never know what's gonna happen.
Holy, this is cold.
We know you can't control the weather, so we build things to harness it.
Woo! That was a good one.
That's amazing, straight above our heads. That's just incredible.
Man, how do we do that? This is where I want to be right now.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, considerable cloudiness, slight chance of a rain shower. High 86. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 72. Thursday, scattered thunderstorms, high 85. Chance of rain, 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
It may seem strange, but people really can love their laxative, especially when it's Miralax. It hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock your system naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative, Miralax.
Want to know a secret? I wasn't always a redhead. You'd never know it, though, because it's nice and easy.
Color so natural-looking, it's Clairol's number one.
Authentic color that's always true to you. So shift to shade and still look like your most amazing you.
Discover Can-Am's wide range of industry-leading vehicles during the Ready to Ride sales event. For a limited time, the Outlander L starts at $59.99. Or get the versatile Commander, the powerful Outlander, and the turbocharged Maverick XDS with cash rebates up to $2,000. Don't miss out. Visit your local dealer during the Ready to Ride sales event. Can-Am, the ride says it all.
This is Bob. Bob's on a first date, so he's not thinking about where to buy his next set of tires. But if he were, all he'd need to know is TireRack.com. Right now, he could get a $70 Visa prepaid card when he buys a set of four select Bridgestone tires. For details, he'd go to TireRack.com/Bridgestone offer. But Bob's not thinking about tires. Bob's thinking, should I tell her about that thing in her teeth? TireRack.com. Find, deliver, install.
Do you have any concerns about your health and life? Do you know that new scientific discoveries are extending healthy lifespans right now? Get the latest life-changing free information for your health. Life Extension, leading research since 1977 with the latest for you to live a healthier, longer life. Get the latest free life-changing information for you at healthandlife.org.
Hey girl, is it crazy that your soccer trophy is talking to you right now? It kind of is. It's as crazy as you not rolling over your old 401k. Cue the horns. Just harness the confidence it took you to win me and call TD Ameritrade's rollover consultants. They'll help with the hassle by guiding you through the whole process step by step. And they'll even call your old provider. It's easy. Even she could do it.
Whatever, Janet.
For all the confidence you need, TD Ameritrade. You got this.
Have been shattering records. Look at this Sam.
I'm getting soaked.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
You know, we're still talking about some wintry weather well north of the severe zone today. We'll get back to the severe weather in a second, but for now, it's time for the winter weather update. Here in the lab, Dr. Greg Postel. Spring snowstorms, not unheard of in this part of the world, but a lot of people ready to throw in the towel for winter.
Yeah, Arrowhead in Minnesota getting some snow. Duluth actually now looks like, according to the radar, transitioning from snow over to rain. So even in far northern Minnesota in late March, sometimes it's hard to get snow, and they actually haven't had a lot this year so far. It's been pretty dry in terms of the amount of snowfall that they've had, but they're getting some right now as a sort of overall relatively weak system moves through the upper Great Lakes.
And it really shows you the strength of the warm fronts associated with the two storms that came through the center of the country, one with severe weather yesterday, another one today. That southerly flow is really cranking.
Yep, and you know what? Tomorrow we've got a chance for some wintry weather across parts of the Ohio Valley, even Indianapolis, Cleveland, Detroit. Watch out for a wintry mix of things tomorrow, and then off into parts of interior New York State, Pennsylvania, and northern New England tomorrow night and Friday as well. The coast looks like it's going to be rain this time around.
The lake's not frozen over completely anymore, so some lake enhancement possible. The snow will linger there a little bit longer.
Yeah, I'm liking this. If I live in Boston, I'm thinking, thank goodness.
Right?
Thank goodness it's raining. I am done. And that's a good thing. But the problem is, you can't put away the cold winter gear yet because we know it's going to get cold there as we head through the weekend. The jet stream is going to take on a pretty high amplitude Friday, Saturday, Sunday. That's going to allow much colder air to sink into the eastern third of the country.
It is a powerful cold front rolling through from the plains into the east. You'll really notice that change in between the fronts, places like D.C. near 75. Behind the front this weekend, so much colder.
Yeah, it's going to be 25 degrees below average across many of those places. Whereas, of course, on the flip side of things, if you happen to live in central South Dakota, I know many of you viewers out there are watching us from central South Dakota, it'll be 25 degrees above average. That's pretty good.
Yeah, you know what? And really further west from there, we'd love to see the pattern flip and get cold and rainy conditions out west where the drought continues. But in the east, it is all about that cold air push.
It's going to get into Florida. I mean, this cold air is not going to stop at the Georgia border to Florida. It's going to keep going. So be prepared for that. And, of course, farther to the north, that's where it's really going to be most impactful. If you look at Boston, in the next 7 days, there's only one of those days that is above average for your high temperature, and that's tomorrow. The rest of the days, below average.
Yeah, and although the averages are coming up this time of year, because, hey, we got the higher sun angle, it's later in the season, but that said, it's too much. And in the south, the growing season started already, and we're talking below freezing temps.
Yeah, we're not that far from our typical latest 32-degree day here in Atlanta, but Florida, you'll get into the I'm sure there are going to be places in the panhandle that will be in the 30s on Sunday morning. 27 in Nashville, 27 in Raleigh. Winter's trying to say, I'm not done yet.
Yeah, it's a chilly dog walk in those mornings, that's for sure. Viv, back to you.
All right, thanks, guys. Well, from the wintry side back to the stormy side of this storm, this is the second day that Springfield, Missouri could feel the sting of severe storms. Our own Keith Carson is there, and he shows us some of the hail and the area as it faced yesterday.
Springfield, Missouri, once again under the gun for some severe weather today. It was a possibility yesterday. We did have some pretty good hail across much of the region. Ping pong sized hail was the largest described. A lot of that hail was actually because of how high the storms were into the atmosphere. You get into that colder air as you go higher up, and that makes hail, which obviously is just a ball of ice more or less, easier to produce and then fall down from the cloud. So we're going to be dealing with that again today as we're likely to see those elevated supercells once again. The cloud base being high, hail going to be a possibility. Probably about the same size as what we saw yesterday. And I think, honestly, at least across southwest Missouri, that's the biggest threat today. We have some limiting factors for tornadoes. Of course, we're going to continue to watch that, and any warnings should be taken seriously. But the setup right now, with not a ton of moisture at the low levels, doesn't seem super conducive to certainly a lot of tornadoes. So I think hail, large hail, damaging hail, will be a problem here today and through the early part of tonight. Back to you.
Okay, let's see what's going on right now because those storms have already started to fire, in particular over the southeastern parts of Kansas. That's where we've already had reports of pea-sized, even nickel and golf ball-sized hailstones. Here is the setup. This is the visible satellite superimposed with the radar. And right there in southeastern Kansas, the southwestern parts of Missouri, look at these storms. Again, severe thunderstorm warnings are out on these because of the hailers. Again, we've had reports of these hailstones, at least the size of golf balls, up to golf ball size hailstones in southwestern Missouri, right in the Springfield area where Keith Carson is located. We're finding severe thunderstorm warnings here. These storms are moving east to northeast, so watch out if you're in the path of these storms because they do contain high winds and hailstones so far. We'll be right back.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, considerable cloudiness, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 72. Thursday, scattered thunderstorms, high 85, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Right now on Weather Center Live, we're tracking another round of severe weather. 10 million people are at risk today for these storms. They could produce more scenes like this. Take a look. Large hailstones, gusty winds, even a greater risk of tornadoes today. We're timing it all for you, city by city.
And yet we still can't say it ain't snow because the white stuff is still falling. We're talking about the wintry side of this spring storm. It's all part of an extreme pattern that we're going to break down for you. Our expert-filled, in-depth live coverage starts right here, right now on Weather Center Live.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Vivian Brown.
And I'm Mark Elliott. And Viv, we are in spring and we're seeing that clash of the seasons. A winter that just won't quit is part of it.
Yes, spring did not spring on time as it got off kind of to a slow start, but those storms are ramping up right now. Take a look at the area that we're watching for the greatest risk of the storms, anywhere from just north of the Red River through much of central eastern Oklahoma, spreading all the way into Missouri. St. Louis, you're somewhat included, but a greater threat over the southern and western parts of the state, so this whole area is suspect today. Here's Mark with the current conditions.
Yeah, Viv, the storms have fired up, mostly along and just north of a warm front. Right now, we are looking at storms that are just over the border of Missouri into Kansas. We've got this severe thunderstorm warning that continues until 1:15. Biggest risk here is the hail. We've seen hail size approaching 2 inches in diameter. Now we move towards Springfield and I-44. This is in Missouri. These storms have been packing a punch as well. Wind and hail with those storms as well. And those are the biggest threats today. So we want to go out to the lab now where Dr. Greg Postel is standing by. Doc, some nasty hailers out there right now and the potential for tornadoes as the day goes on.
Yeah, there's a cluster of pretty good storms across parts of southeastern Kansas and southwestern Missouri. Let's look at the satellite and the radar composite to show you where they're developing. Right out in here, they've been going on for the last hour or two. We've gotten lots of reports of hail inside of that zone up to 2 inches, as you mentioned, in diameter. So that is enough to do damage, certainly to car roofs or even regular house roofs, too. I mean, could do some shingle and tree limb damage as well. Let's have a look at where these storms are in relation to surface warm fronts hanging out here. And these storms are forming along and just north of that from about Independence, Kansas, all the way to Springfield, Missouri. Let's look at some of those warnings out here now. Neosho County in Kansas until 1:15 p.m. Possibility of this storm producing some golf ball size hail as it moves on off toward the northeast at about 30 miles per hour. Let's move the radar over now into in the Missouri side and show you that near Springfield, Missouri, we got a couple of warnings out here. Let's zoom in on this guy. For Greene County, Missouri, for the cities of Republic, Springfield, and Willard, that is until 1:15, and this one is in effect until 1:45, this severe thunderstorm warning for Dallas, Greene, and Polk counties. Again, the hazards of these storms are hail up to the size of golf balls and winds up to 60 miles per hour. Let's look at some of the hail tracks that have been shown with these particular storms. You absolutely can see the storm motion here. It's to the northeast just like that. So it looks like the heaviest of the hail right now is going to move just to the west of Springfield, with the radar estimating the hail sizes in here up to about 1.5 inches, which is actually matching up pretty well with some of the hail sizes that we've seen here back over in Kansas. We've got a report of almost 1 inch hail size there, but a lot of those hailstones coming together that cover the ground at the intersection of Highway 75 and 700. So we have a hail event going on here right near the warm front there, just to the north of Tulsa. Later on today, I'd say in about 3 or 4 hours, we're going to see new development of thunderstorms along and just ahead of this dry line here. And those storms are going to be moving into an environment that is right now becoming progressively more unstable. So these storms that form here in southwestern Oklahoma in a few hours will move into central Oklahoma and potentially become severe this afternoon, where we've got the outlook here set up showing you that the severe weather risk does indeed go all the way from Wichita Falls up through Springfield and northeastward from there. Looking at the ingredients in play, we have a lot of available energy for those thunderstorms to tap. That's that area shaded in yellow where the highest available potential energy resides. So those storms could become real big and real strong pretty quickly. And in that environment, there's a lot of wind shear. If you look at the surface wind flow like that, the mid-level wind flow like that, there is a lot of potential for these storms to rotate, to use that wind shear. And in that environment where there's a lot of instability, watch out for the possibility of some big storms. So we have have the strong shear and the instability working together to give you a Torcon value of 4, 40% chance of a tornado within 50 miles of a point. Back to you.
Southwest Missouri is in the bullseye when it comes to today's storm threat. So joining us now is David Gady with the National Weather Service office out of Springfield, Missouri. Now, David, thanks for joining us. Well, we've already seen some thunderstorm warnings across parts of Arkansas for sure. Are you surprised that the storms are firing up already so early in the afternoon?
No, not really. Down there in the warm sector, we would expect thunderstorms to be developing at this time here. Up here in southwest Missouri, we're kind of looking for mid to late afternoon for our severe thunderstorms to develop.
Yes, we're already beginning to see some of the ingredients come together for some parts. Let's talk more about the gusty winds and the hailstones that you saw yesterday. What did you see as the biggest threats yesterday?
Well, yesterday it was predominantly hail. We were getting reports of hail up to an inch and a half in diameter. We did get a couple of reports of some wind damage, but most of the damage was, most of the reports were from hail.
Yeah, an inch and a half, that's at least a little bit larger than quarters, and those winds were up to at least 50, 55 miles per hour.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, this season is getting underway, you know, a bit later than it does on average. Does that surprise you?
Well, no, not really. Mm-hmm. I mean, this time of year, the weather here in southwest Missouri it normally gears up about this time of year.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks very much. That is David Gady with the National Weather Service office out of Springfield, Missouri. Of course, in the target area for severe weather today, and we will keep you updated as the watches and warnings are issued throughout the afternoon.
And one of the risks today is also for tornadoes. And we gauge the risk for possible tornadoes with a tool developed by our severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes. It's called the Tornado Condition Index. We shorten it to TORCON. And here's what it means. You can see it here. If we have a 3 on the scale, you multiply that by 10. It gives you a percentage chance of seeing a tornado in any 50-mile radius around that TORCON point. And it helps you judge just how large the risk is for your neck of the woods when you have a TORCON value that will increase or decrease as the risk changes. Viv, over to you. Or we'll continue to talk about the TORCON, because hey, we've got this severe threat continuing through the rest of today. We'll break it down when we return.
You pay your auto insurance premium every month on the dot. You're like the poster child for paying on time. And then one day, you tap the bumper of a station wagon. No big deal, until your insurance company jacks up your rates. You freak out. What good is having insurance if you get punished for using it? Hey, insurance companies, newsflash. Nobody's perfect.
For drivers with accident forgiveness, Liberty Mutual won't raise your rates due to your first accident. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
This Jesus cult grows stronger by the hour. Take him and crucify him.
Killing him won't be the end of him.
Bible continues Easter Sunday, April 5th on NBC.
I have a cold with terrible chest congestion. Better take something.
Theraflu Severe Cold doesn't treat chest congestion.
Really?
New Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Powder rushes relief to your worst cold symptoms plus chest congestion.
Oh, what a relief it is.
Here we go!
You know your dentures can move. Unlike natural teeth, try Fixit Plus TrueFeel. The smooth formula helps keep dentures in place. It's free of flavors and colorants for a closer feeling to natural teeth. Fix it in and forget it.
But now, let's put this out here.
I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this sample.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, considerable cloudiness, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 72. Thursday, scattered thunderstorms, high 85. Chance of rain, 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Sundays.
One man's trash
did the work.
This is another man's totally awesome beer can space heater.
Hi. Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Who needs a witness when you set the world in motion? The full line of Ram ProMaster vans. And the all-new Ram ProMaster City. Purpose-built to help you run the town. Ram.
It tastes better when you grow it. It tastes even better when you share it. It's not hard. It's doable. It's growable. Get going with Growables. Miracle-Gro. Life starts here.
Oh, cool. I can check my credit score on Credit Karma.
Checking your credit score is for chumps. I have great credit.
How do you know?
Duh.
You know those change, right?
Tattoos don't change.
Try Credit Karma. It's free, and you can see what your score is right now. Aren't you a little bit curious?
I just got my free credit score.
Credit Karma. Really free credit scores. Really free.
I've got to update my ink.
Happening now, here's a setup for severe weather. It's already begun. We've had some large hail being reported. And we've got a warm front that's charging north through Oklahoma. Oklahoma City is at 81, while Dodge City is only at 61. Storms have been forming as the air gets lifted over that front. So a lot of the storms have been just north of the warm front, but that doesn't mean they haven't been severe. This is in Kansas. We do have this severe thunderstorm warning until 1:15. Big hail being reported in this area. Some of the estimates are close to 2 inches in diameter. Sometimes that's aloft and the hailstones can collide and break apart a bit before they reach the ground, but still the potential for large hail is there. And then storms moved right over Springfield, now mostly just north of I-44. Hail and wind have been the threats here along the I-44 corridor. We're going to continue to follow these storms as they continue to race on off towards the north and east. Viv.
All right, well, let's talk more about the snowy side of things, because this system is two-sided. It's still winter across parts of Minnesota. You're looking at chunks of ice still near the river in the Duluth area. So the air is still cold enough and it hasn't warmed up to just melt all of the ice and even the chunks of ice that we're finding in the river. Even looking at additional snow across the area. Duluth right here, one batch of snow pushing through the area as we speak. We have another batch that's just exiting from the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. But nonetheless, we're still talking about the winter weather radar active today. Even some wet conditions, chilly rain for the most part over the west central parts of Pennsylvania and New York. Okay, we have two systems, two different areas of low pressure. Both of these will be moving off to the east, but we think this one will just kind of reinforce the colder air and let us know that winter is trying to hang on as long as it can, because notice by tomorrow afternoon, still a little slither of wintry weather crossing over the eastern Great Lakes, moving into western New York and Pennsylvania to the tune of 1 to 3 inches of snow we're expecting here still to come from these systems moving across this region. So here you have it, the official forecast for you, Duluth, looking at snow, even though it will be coming to an end, kind of mixing in with some chilly rain as temperatures will remain in the mid to upper 30s. And here's a look at the forecast over Berlin, New Hampshire. Some additional light snow for you as well. Mark?
So yeah, we've got a wintry side to this mess, but parts of the Northeast have been dealing with rain, and rain will continue to move in. How about Detroit, Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., all with overcast skies, slate gray conditions. And you know, the storms in the Ozarks from yesterday, at least in part, that same storm system responsible for the soggy conditions for the rest of the Northeast. It's going to be wet. It's going to be warmer, at least temporarily, across the east. So storm number one, this is the storm generally that brought the severe weather in the center of the country yesterday. This is the warm front that's racing north and east. It's bringing mostly rain here across the Northeast corridor. You see the purple showing up there? Those are the colder valleys of central Pennsylvania in between some of the mountains. That cold air stuck in between, giving some freezing rain, at least according to the radar. Kind of cool to see the topography there. So yes, our warm front continues to push north and east through the rest of the day. Precip eventually gets all the way through Maine, and the warm air continues to push on in. But really, all this does is set the stage for the next storm system, because it's going to be warmer, there's going to be more moisture involved, and a powerhouse cold front is going to be working its way towards the east. That front is going to be a cruel return to reality. It's going to bring us rain, maybe some thunderstorms along the front Wednesday into Thursday and Friday, and then also usher back in the much cooler air. So today, warm front number one going through. Temps in the 40s for New York and Philly. Look at tomorrow. Philly's at 70. DC's at 75. Unfortunately, that doesn't stay around. That cold front does come through and really changes the picture. Back to the low 50s, Viv, by Friday.
All right. Well, we have a question for you. What do these two cities have in common, Phoenix, Arizona, and Charleston, South Carolina, other than the fact that they both are in the southern half of the nation, other than the fact that they are both beautiful cities? We'll tell you what else they have in common as Weather Center Live rolls on.
Going to the paint studio at Ace is like going to your neighbor. And hurry in this Wednesday through Sunday for buy 1 gallon, get one free. Save up to $71 when you buy 2 gallons, exclusively at Ace.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Ugh, heartburn.
Did someone say burn? Try Alka-Seltzer Relief Chews. They work just as fast and are proven to taste better than Tums Smoothies Assorted Fruit.
Amazing.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. Enjoy the relief.
According to the U.S. Department of Energy, most homes have air leaks and drafts that waste so much energy, it's like leaving a window open in your home all year long. Don't let another year go by. Call Champion Windows at 844-4-CHAMPION. And right now, when you buy 2 rooms of windows, you get the 3rd room free. Plus, Champion now offers no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. So call 844-4-CHAMPION today. Because every home needs a champion.
The FDA issued a public notice to doctors and patients concerning serious injuries caused by transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, and bladder sling. Please call now if you had one of these devices implanted in the last 5 years. You may be entitled to a cash award. If you had a transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, or bladder sling in the last 5 years,
please call 1-866-686-7952 now.
But now, let's put this out here.
I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
The FDA issued a public notice to doctors and patients concerning serious injuries caused by transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, and bladder sling. Please call now if you had one of these devices implanted in the last 5 years. You may be entitled to a cash award. If you had a transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, or bladder sling in the last 5 years,
please call 1-855-305-2053 now.
It makes me happy to go on the computer. I like feeling smart.
Internet Essentials from Comcast has brought low-cost internet access to over 1.4 million low-income people at home.
Internet Essentials helped me progress in my schoolwork. It helped my grades move higher.
Today, it's the largest broadband adoption program in America.
It helped me a lot.
Comcast NBC Universal, helping to bridge the digital divide.
Sundays.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8s brought to you by Duracell, trusted to outlast the storm.
I've seen hurricanes, floods, I've seen tornadoes. We give out Duracell batteries after the worst happens. And when the power's out for days, we stay with them. You might say they lost everything, but that's not what I see. I see a different kind of power. I saw it in Ruth, Adam, Tom. It's the power they have inside of them. The power to move forward.
At Duracell, we believe that's the power that never, ever goes out.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, considerable cloudiness, slight chance of a rain shower. High 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 72. Thursday, scattered thunderstorms. High 85, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
You could say it's a tale of two cities. Los Angeles, a sunny, very dry, very hot pattern, while Raleigh on the right side of your screen has the slate gray skies and the chance for really chilly stuff. The winter has divided the country in two, and spring is starting out in a very similar note. It is an extreme weather pattern that will set up through the rest of the week and really continue. So we want to head to the lab. Vivian's there talking about how this pattern sets up and divides the country.
That is right, Mark. We are a nation divided temperature-wise. It's all because the jet stream is just very amplified. We have a deep trough of low pressure over the eastern half of the country, but a big ridge of high pressure across the west, and both represent different things in the way of the air and the heat or the lack of. Now, when you have this deep trough of low pressure, that will allow all of the cold air from Canada and the Northwest Territories, even the Arctic, to push southward. Of course, it will modify as it moves south of the border, but cooler air over the east nonetheless. In the meantime, we have the big ridge of high pressure with the jet stream punching all the way into Canada, so that's pretty much allowing all of the tropical influenced air to push pretty far north. Take a look now. Afternoon highs running a good 15 to 25 degrees above average with the ridge over the west, but 25 degrees below average perhaps over the east with that trough of low pressure. So here is a look at the particulars. Atlanta, look at Friday, your afternoon high only in the low 60s, but if you think that's chilly, what about Saturday? Not really getting out of the 50s, low to mid 50s, and Saturday morning dropping down to the mid-30s, but literally freezing when you wake up Sunday morning in the Atlanta area, and even colder than that in Raleigh. Look at that, Sunday morning down into the mid-20s. So please be prepared for the colder air. Not so much, though, if you're over the west, because the big ridge of high pressure here, in fact, we're talking about possible record highs in the west from Los Angeles over to Las Vegas. Look at Saturday, your afternoon high, Las Vegas, 91 degrees. And much of the same even tomorrow in Los Angeles, up to 91 possible records. You know, we'll keep you updated. All right, back to you, Mark. A nation divided as far as temperatures go.
Yeah, and in between that division, we've got severe weather for the second day in a row, and it could be the most widespread threat that we've had in months. Oklahoma, straight on up through Missouri and Arkansas. Today we are going to be flying into this zone to show you exactly where those threats set up and when. We start things off near Oklahoma City, and the storm threat for you starts off later this afternoon towards 5 p.m., but the biggest threat for you will be huge hail and gusty winds. There's also that Torcon of 4, about a 40% chance of seeing a tornado. Jumping up towards Springfield, Missouri on I-44, timing starting now. We've had storms go through, but later today a second round between 5 and 10 o'clock, also a Torcon of 4. So for now, it's the hail up and north of the warm front. Later today, it could very well be the tornado threat. We can time this out for you in motion here as we go through the day. It looks like those storms form basically along I-44. By between 4 and 6 o'clock, the storms really get going. They are going to continue to work their way off towards the east. So by 8 p.m. or so, we are going to continue to see that really near near Springfield, Missouri. Again, Springfield, you had a round of storms go through already today. Second round comes in this evening, and then lingering rain. So we may even have some problems with ponding and flooding on the roads. That's something that we're going to watch carefully. So by later on tonight, as we lose some of that daytime heating and we lose some of that oomph in the atmosphere, a lot of the biggest storms will fizzle out. Potential for some big storms to still be hanging out here in southern Oklahoma or North Texas. They were handing out some weather alert radios in North Texas yesterday because of this very threat. So hopefully you are prepared. As we go through the night, again, it's North Texas through southern Missouri, maybe as far towards the east as Kentucky and Tennessee. You have to have a way to get your warnings, especially after dark. That's when storms become even that much more dangerous. We'll fine-tune all of this forecast when we return.
Sometimes bigger is better. But other times, bigger just gets in the way. At Brother, we know the biggest printer isn't always the best fit for every office. So we've come up with a bigger idea. Don't supersize, optimize. See how we can help you put the right printers in all the right places and help reduce your costs. Now that's big. Brother, at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
Incredible. I've been Claritin Clear for 10 days.
When your allergy symptoms start, doctors recommend taking one Claritin every day of your allergy season for continuous relief.
With powerful 24-hour non-drowsy Claritin, live Claritin Clear. Every day.
Hey everybody, I'm Julianne Hough. When your face is broken out and nothing you try is working, you feel out of control. I know I did. But now, there's an exciting breakthrough from America's number one acne brand. It's called Proactive Plus. What does the plus mean? It means more. More medicine that now works even faster, and more skin-loving ingredients to visibly address dark marks, oily shine, redness, and enlarged pores, giving you skin that's not only clear, but bright, beautiful, and younger looking too.
Introducing Proactive Plus, our breakthrough combination of smarter acne medicine plus ultra-perfecting skincare. The results will amaze you.
The results were crazy incredible. My skin was getting brighter, my breakouts were clearing up. I don't think my skin has ever looked this good.
It's the best Proactive ever, and the buzz is off the charts.
I love, love Proactive Plus. My pores look smaller now, way smaller, and my skin feels velvety, smooth, and moisturized.
Proactive Plus gives you one solution, so many amazing results. Acne medicine and skincare this good could cost over $200. But call now and get Proactive Plus not for $200, not $100, but for the special introductory price of just $19.95. And if you order now, you get free shipping.
You deserve to feel confident with skin that's more beautiful than you ever dreamed possible. And now you can with Proactive Plus.
Act fast and call 1-800-382-0753 to receive a deluxe trio. They're the doctor's special extras for gorgeous skin. Yours free. Imagine all this, a $105 value for the limited introductory price of just $19.95.
Proactive Plus really is awesome. It really does work.
Guaranteed to give you clear, flawless-looking skin or your money back. Call 1-800-382-0753 now.
But now, let's put this out here.
I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, considerable cloudiness, slight chance of a rain shower, high 86, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 72. Thursday, scattered thunderstorms. High 85. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Never know what's going to happen.
Woo! That was a good one.
Well, the threat of severe storms continues today from the Midwest to the Ohio Valley and especially the South Central states. Look at this. This was video shot yesterday in Springfield, Missouri. You can feel the rotation in those clouds. This is a supercell thunderstorm, the types of storms that often produce large hail and can produce tornadoes. Springfield, when this rolled through, saw heavy rain. You saw thunder, lightning, and nickel-sized hail. There's a potential for big hail today and a lot of wind in the storms that roll by. Thanks for sticking with us. It's Weather Center Live, and I'm Mark Elliott.
And I'm Vivian Brown. Now, when you're dealing with severe weather, it can be very dangerous and scary. You can see more large hailstones today, damaging winds, even tornadoes, as you mentioned, Mark. Let's take you back to yesterday, because we were looking at the radar, and right at the start of the 4 o'clock hour is when radar detected that lone little cluster of storms over southeastern Kansas and southwestern Missouri. 2 hours later, look how those storms just panned out as they approached the Springfield, Missouri area, and then kind of died down a little bit as they moved off to the east. But nonetheless, it was between 4 and 6 hours late yesterday evening that we were dealing with the severe storms. And that potential exists again today. Right, Mark?
Yeah, it most certainly does. We are going to see severe weather. Here is a look at the severe outlook. We're looking from North Texas through Oklahoma into Arkansas, southern Missouri. There is going to be that zone of that potential for storms. Big hail, gusty winds, isolated tornadoes, all a potential within this area as we go through the rest of today into tonight. This severe storm threat does continue as we go into the nighttime hours, so that's certainly something to be wary of as well. Viv, over to you.
Okay, now we know the target zone, that red shaded area. If you live there, we want you to keep an eye to the sky, or better yet, keep it tuned here to the Weather Channel. You know we're here watching the radars. In fact, our storm specialist, Dr. Postel, is in the lab looking at the radars, the upper air charts, to give us a precise look on the changes in the atmosphere. What's going on right now, Dr. Postel?
Viv and Mark, thank you guys very much. We have some big thunderstorms now in southern Kansas and southwestern Missouri, primarily hail producers and some gusty winds as well, up to 50 miles per hour. Let's have a look at the satellite pictures with the radar on top of that to show you where we're talking. In that zone between Wichita and Springfield, Missouri, thunderstorms over the last couple of hours have erupted in that area. This is right along and just north of a warm front where it's sort of the zone, the confluent zone between some humid air coming northward out of the Gulf of Mexico like that and some, I would say, not really cool air, but air coming out of a different direction that's slightly drier. But you get the sense that the air is converging here along that warm front, and it is along and just north of that that we're seeing a lot of the forcing for ascent. So the air parcels are being lifted right along that zone, and that's why we're seeing those thunderstorms blossom in here. And there have been largely hail producers so far today. We have a couple of severe thunderstorms warning out. Now, this is in southeastern Kansas for Barton, Crawford, and Vernon counties until 2:15 p.m. Central Time. And over here in Missouri side here, we have a severe thunderstorm warning for Dallas, Greene, and Webster counties. That one had just expired in front of your eyes, and we're looking now at Webster County in Missouri, just to the northeast of Springfield. That is where the latest severe thunderstorm warning is, with this cluster of storms right here still along and just north of I-44. These have been hail producers. Looking at the hail tracks, this is according to the radar. You can actually very clearly see the storm motion here. This is where the storms are going, toward the northeast at about 35 miles per hour. We've got some pretty decent hail size reports, 1.3 inches. That is at the National Weather Service office there in Springfield, Missouri. So hailers moving northeastward at 35 across southeastern Kansas and southwestern Missouri. That's been the story for the last couple of hours. That will continue to be the story for the next couple of hours. But we will also have to watch new thunderstorm development across this zone where the sun is out, the air is getting more and more unstable, temperatures are in the 80s already. And as that dry line, this yellow guy, that yellow squiggle, as that moves that way, and it's going to help initiate thunderstorms along it across parts of central Oklahoma, perhaps even in the Oklahoma City area, where this afternoon the instability will be pretty high. CAPES, they're called, convective available potential energy, above 2,000 joules per kilogram in that zone. So these storms will be able to use that energy, that instability, and grow real tall and strong and last a while as well. And that matches up in that area where we expect the most severe storms to occur through the late evening hours. Let's time it out now across the southern plains. Here we go. Boom! Here's an area of thunderstorms developing quickly. That's along the bulge of the dry line moving across Oklahoma. So this is the dry line cluster of storms. And this right here, that's along that warm front. It's going to continue to be convectively active up that way. And then eventually we're going to see the cold front take over near Oklahoma City by about 8 o'clock tonight. So we'll see new development probably along that cold front, which will overtake the dry line this evening. And we'll just have a lot of thunderstorm activity through the evening hours into the overnight. So really overall, in terms of tornado threat, we have a Torcon index of 4 across this region, 40% chance of a tornado within 50 miles. The primary hazards today remain large hail and damaging winds up to 60 miles per hour. But with a Torcon of 4, could remain a busy afternoon. Dr. Forbes will be here all afternoon and evening to keep you updated on the latest. Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Dr. Postel. And we want everyone to check this out. This just sent into the Weather Channel, hail in Ash Grove, Missouri.
And you can see those individual hailstone pellets just almost covering the ground here. So this is what happens when you get that cold air aloft and you get those strong updrafts. It can create some pretty large hailstones. And as they fall, they could do quite a bit of damage.
Yeah, Austin, thanks so much for sending this one in. And you can do the same. If you can do it safely and you're in a zone with severe weather, send us your images and we'll show everyone what you're dealing with.
All right. In the meantime, North Texas emergency managers, they are making last-minute checks to make sure the public is prepared and informed ahead of the storms.
Yes. Chris Van Horn from affiliate KXAS takes a look at the steps officials are taking after a number of outdoor warning sirens malfunctioned in recent months.
The skies are clear, but the Texas winds are whipping. As the first chance for severe weather approaches, those whose job it is to make sure the public is warned are ready as they check and fix warning sirens like this one on West Bonds Ranch Road in far north Fort Worth. No siren test today, but nearby resident Destiny Anderson is glad to know it's working whenever the next emergency or test happens.
It's a good time to teach